Hello all, welcome to oratennis.com. In this Oracle Database Programming course, we'll discuss about select and from clause in this particular session. Let us get into outline. We'll understand about what is SQL, different types of SQL statements, and different set of DML commands, and we'll have a deeper discussion of the select and from clause. The objectives of this particular session are we should be capable enough to understand how do we execute a basic select statement and the different set of DML statements which are available in Oracle database. So let us get into the basics of SQL. What is SQL? SQL is nothing but a structured query language, which has set of commands which allows us to extract the data from database. They are divided into different set of groups. Basically, we generally call them as DDL, DML, and DCL. DDL stands for data definition language. It will have a set of commands which we use it for the purpose of creating database object. Example, table, procedure, function, trigger, type, sequence, object, there are many more. So this DDL commands or DDL set of statements or DDL commands provide set of commands using which we can create an object, alter an object, we can drop an object, okay? And they are auto commit, nothing but like when you create a table, it doesn't need to explicitly mention commit statement. The object will get created after the successful execution of the command. The next set of commands are divided into DML, data manipulation language. So this DML language commands provides set of commands which we use it for the purpose of performing DML operations, or we can also call them as CRUD operations, nothing but create, read, update, and delete. So they are divided. These four things, like a select, insert, update, and delete. The next one is called data control language, which we use it for the purpose of controlling the privileges for a given user. Let us say you want to give only read-only privileges for a user on a particular table, like providing a grant privileges on a particular table or a function or a procedure, let us say you want to restrict the user from creating any database object. You want to restrict the user from dropping a particular table. So these set of things will come into DCL. So let us try to get more information of the select clause of the DML commands. So in this session, we'll discuss about the DML commands, but in the DML commands, we'll start with select as well as from clause first. So how do we write a basic select statement in the database? So what is the purpose of select statement? The purpose of a select statement is to retrieve the data which is available in the database table. In a database, the only object which stores the data is table. In addition to the database table, there is another object called materialized view, which is also having a capability to store the data. Okay, but generally, most of the times we use only database table. Of course, materialized views will be used in very, very rare scenarios. Okay, let us concentrate on the table. So how do we retrieve the data from the database table? So to retrieve the data from the database table, we require a select query. We have to understand how do we write a select query so that we can fetch the data from the database table. So here we have provided the basic syntax of the select statement. So here, if you observe the syntax here, so we have select clause, nothing. We also call it as a keyword, or you can call it as a clause. Select is the Oracle database keyword. From is Oracle database keyword. And also these all things right here, like a distinct is also Oracle keyword. And table is a developer defined object, okay? So how do we write a simple select query? We have to mention a select clause followed by the column name. If you don't want to mention a column name, you can mention asterisk. So here, if you observe, we have mentioned a piping symbol. It means that either of them, nothing but you can mention asterisk or any of this available particular things based on your requirement. You can mention a distinct followed by column name, or you can mention a mathematical expression, or you can mention some kind of static value, as well as you can also mention a column alias, so on and so forth. And then we have to mention from clause followed by a table name, a valid table name. So here, if you observe, what is the difference between a select as well as from here means? Select identifies what columns you want to show in the output. From identifies from which particular table you want to retrieve the output. Nothing but from identifies the source of your data. Select identifies which particular columns you want to show in the output. Okay, so let us write a simple select statement first. Okay, so I'll just open my database table. Okay, so here if you observe, I'll just write a simple command to retrieve the data from a particular table, right? So as we have seen a simple example, select is a keyword, and I want to retrieve all the columns from a particular table. So I have mentioned a from clause, followed by you have to mention a particular table, right? So this is how we have to mention. So this is just a simple syntax we have to consider now. So I'll just write here, select star from a table EMP. And here after EMP, I mentioned a semicolon, okay? And then like there are a number of shortcuts available in SQL Developer. So how do I execute? There are many ways. You can simply select your query. You can mention this arrow mark, nothing but run statement like this, you can do it. Or you can just mention, like let us say I just ended my select query here by mentioning a semicolon at the end of the statement. And you can just press Control Enter. So this is another way of executing. Or you have another way also, simply F5. Place your cursor on the valid select query which you want to execute and press F5. This is another way of executing a query. But here if you see, when you press F5, you are seeing the output in the script output, but when you press Control Enter, you are seeing the output in the query result. That's the difference, okay? Now, so what we have done, we have mentioned a select query by mentioning select clause, asterisk, from clause, and EMP. Now here, if you observe, we got the output, right? So nothing but this query has a result. This query, when we executed, it provided the output in this particular table region, right? So what all it provided, just observe carefully, just right click on this one and click on count rows. So how many rows it provided? It provided 14 rows, as well as how many columns it provided, just counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So how many we got? We got 14 rows and 8 columns, okay? Now, so in the select syntax, we have seen a little bit different thing also, right? Instead of mentioning asterisk, you can mention a column name, or you can mention distinct keyword, or you can also mention a expression, right? So let us mention a few more things now. Let us say, I just want to retrieve only EMP number and ename. How do I do it? You can mention column name, EMP name, EMP number, ename, from which table? EMP, and then mention semicolon, press Control Enter. Now the difference between a select query at line number 3 as line number 5 is from clause is same, but in the select clause here, if you observe, instead of mentioning star, we mention the two column names. That is why we have seen the output of only two columns, but the number of rows are same. Okay. Now let us select another table. Let us say I just want to retrieve the data from one of my table called HR operating units in Oracle EBS. So I'll just say select star from HR underscore operating units, right? So I'll just mention like this and mention a semicolon and Control Enter. So when you execute a statement with Control Enter, what happens is it will try to validate where is your semicolon, and it will also try to validate where is your select statement. So it will execute the total query like that. Now here, if you observe, let us say I mentioned this HR operating units in some other line and mention and try to execute the Control Enter like this. So now if you observe carefully, what is happening? The 7 from line number 7 to 9, it totally copied and executed it as a single statement. That is a capability of this Control Enter in the SQL Developer. Okay. Now how many rows you got it? You can just mention right click and click on count rows. We got 126 rows. Okay. Now let us get into the next particular thing in our basic select statement. Okay. So here we have provided a simple example of the same thing, right? So let us get into the next one. So what are the rules of selecting a statement? Like when you write a query, what are the rules we have to consider? The SQL statements are not case sensitive. Nothing but any of the Oracle keyword is not case sensitive, but the data is always case sensitive. The way you store it, the way it will store it. And if you want to retrieve it, you have to be careful in performing the retrieval also. Keywords cannot be abbreviated or split into across lines. You cannot, you know, like let us say if you want to write, let us say in this one, what we have done, I've written select and from clause in one line and the table name in another line. Yes, this will work. Or let us say I'll also write like this, select in one clause, star in one clause, from in another, sorry, another line, and then execute it. This will also work. But let us say if you try to mention like this, it will not work, right? So FR in one line, OM in second line, this will not work. This is not a valid syntax. And here, if you observe carefully, SQL Developer automatically gives the error. You just observe this red color line, right? So by this also, you can try to understand, okay, there is some issue at the line number 8, 9, 10, like this, okay? Now, clauses are usually placed on a separate line, nothing but like when you have a select from clause or a where clause, order by clause, it is always, you know, like try to mention them in a different line so that it will be easier for readability. But if you have a very simple query, then you can just go within a single line. But if you have very larger query, the best practice is to divide them to different set of lines for readability purpose or understanding purpose. Okay, next. So the different set of arithmetic operators in the Oracle. So it provides the basic mathematical operators which we generally have in our mathematics, and it follows the BODMAS rule: bracket of division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. Right. So here, if you observe the same information, it like even in our normal mathematics also we follow the same rule, right? Like it will give the precedence based on the bracket, and then you know like a division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. We have to be very careful when you're trying to perform the mathematical operation, and also make sure that you consider the proper precedence rules of your operator and how you want to see the result and how do you want to perform your particular requirement using these particular operators. Okay, so before getting into arithmetic operators, let us write some more samples using the basic select statement, considering the different set of keywords which we have seen. Right, now let us see. I just want to use a distinct keyword on the operating unit stuff. So distinct name from HR operating units, right? So what I mentioned here, I just mentioned distinct keyword followed by a column name from this particular table. So I just got these number of rows, right? Let us say I'll just count it. So I got 126. What does it mean? It means that the name in this particular table is unique. For each particular row, it is unique, right? That's why we got like this. So what I'll do is I'll just try to use, so from the table EMP, select star from EMP. So here, if you observe, I have set of like a department number, which is repeated for set of different set of employees, right? Like I could see 10 got repeated. I could see 20 got repeated, similarly 30. Now I just want to see the distinct department numbers. What I can do, I can just mention select distinct department number from EMP table. So we may get a different result. So we just got only 4 rows, right? And for one of the row, we got null, nothing but no value at all. So out of, if you just ignore the null, nothing but there are 3 departments which are considered here, right? So this is how we can just mention making use of the distinct. Now just observe a few more things, like I'm just going to my initial slide. We have used distinct column. So in the when you mention distinct, it is not that you can mention only single column, you can mention multiple columns also. Let us say I can mention EMP number, I can mention MGR. So you can mention n number of columns, right? So it will try to, first of all, what it will do, it will execute the data. It will execute the data, and after that, it will apply the distinct on each particular row. It will apply distinct on for row wise kind of thing. Now let us see if I remove the distinct, let us see if I remove EMP number, I may get a different result, right? So out of 14 rows, I got only 10 rows. It means that there are few employees for whom the department as well as manager is same. That is the reason you just got only 10 rows instead of 14 rows. Okay, so this is how you can make use of distinct. Now coming to the other thing, like a expression as well as alias. What is expression? Expression can be a mathematical expression, or it can be a static text. So now here, let us say, I'll just use my table again, select star from EMP. Now, what I want to do is, I just want to print EMP number, A name, job, manager, and salary like this. I just want to display only this particular 5 columns. But now what I want to do is I want to calculate annual salary for the employee. Assume this particular salary is for each month, for a given month, or per month. But I want to calculate annual salary for each employee, and I want to display the value across each employee. So what I do, twelve into salary and execute it. Now it is displaying the value, but I don't want to display like 12 into salary. I want to display it as some column name. What you can do, you can mention as annual salary like this. This is one way of mentioning a column alias. This is called column alias. Okay. Now another way is you can mention like this. Let us say, okay. So now what it is telling, it is saying some keyword is not found, right? It is giving a error. So remove this is. You can ignore is also. This will also work. Other ways, you can mention single quotes and you can mention, let us say, if you want to, if at all, if you want to give space, if at all, if you want to give space in your column name, column alias name, then you have to enclose them in double quotes. This is another way. So, and it is also best practice to save your set of commands, which like what are the SQL queries which you work on, right? It's always best thing to save them, right? So I'll just say select clause.sql, save your file so that you can refer them in later point of time. So this is how we can mention column alias. Now let us say I just want to simply provide some text for each and every record. What I'll do is I'll just copy the first one here like this. Now I'll mention some column name like this. Hello. Now this hello is a value which is not available in an EMP table, but this is not a column name. Observe here, this is not a column name. When I execute it, it is providing the value as a column name, but this hello is just a static text which is not available as a column. Okay. Now, if you want to mention a column name for this one, a sample text, I can mention like this, sample text. So this is how we can mention. Okay. So these are some of the examples of a select clause. Okay. Now let us get into our slide. So using arithmetic operations, we can make use of these particular things. Make sure that you use the parentheses properly. Okay. Now, coming to the very important thing in the Oracle database, it is called null value. So what is null value? Why it is so important? And how do we consider? Okay, let us get into examples and then we can try to understand. I can just read these two lines of statement. A null is a value that is unavailable, unassigned, unknown, or inapplicable. So nothing but a null, whenever you see a value null in a particular column, it means that there is no value at all. There is no value at all. It is not equivalent to zero, or it is not equivalent to blank space. There is no value at all in that. There is no memory allocated for that column in the database. Okay, that is very important. Now let us get into some samples of null. Okay, null value. Now, so I'll just query a particular table, a special table, select star from Jewel. Okay, so now this is Jewel is one of the Oracle database Oracle provided table, which we generally use it for the purpose of validating some set of functions or using in the database, in PLSQL programming or in your PL, in SQL programming, many number of times. Okay, so Jewel is a table which is having a single row and single column. Okay, now what I want to do is I just want to write like this: select null from Jewel. Now we know that what is a null? Null is a value. Similar to our hello, null is also value. I'll write hello also here. Let us say comma, hello also I'll write it. So when I execute, what is happening? It is printing null followed by hello. Okay, now let us write one more thing. Let us say, what is the length of null? Just see this. Length of null is null because anything with null is always null. That is what I was telling you, right? For null, there is no space allocated. Let us say, I'll just give a space here and just see the difference. For a space, I could see the length is one. That is the difference between null as well as a space. Or you can also observe one more thing. Let us say you want to calculate the length of zero. Length is a function which calculates the number of characters in it. It can be a number or it can be character, but it just counts the number of characters in it. Alphanumeric, I can say. Okay, now let us see a few more examples of null. Now let us say I'll just go back to my table EMP. Now here, if you observe, there are few values in a particular employee, like where manager is null, commission is null, or you can see some employees where commission is having value, few employees commission does not have value, right? Now let us say what I want to do is I just want to see a new commission percentage by adding up. So what I want to do is provide 10% additional commission for each employee as a bonus. But I want to see what is the new commission percentage also. So what I'll do is select EMP number, e name, job, manager, commission, become EMP. So first of all, let us try to print the existing one. And what is the new commission I want to see the? I want to just see the commission percentage, 10% increment, right? 10% increment. So what is the 10% increment? Commission plus, there are a number of ways you can do it, right? Commission into one, new commission, new com. That's it. Now, what is happening? Here, if you observe for a employee record or employee row number 8, Alan, the value of a old commission is 300 and the new was 330. Okay. And here, if you observe, what is the thing? Earlier it was null and new commission is also null. Obviously, right? You don't have value earlier. And why will you have a new, why will you have a value now? We cannot have it. But let us say what we can do is, let us say we can add up one more clause saying that for employees whose commission earlier was null, give them 500. Then how do we do it? Now what I want to do is, when I execute this one, I want to see 500 wherever the earlier commission was null. So for this, we have to use a different logic, right? For that, Oracle provided a function called NVL, nothing but null value. Wherever null value is there, it will provide you alternate value, nothing but the syntax of NVL function is, let us say I have a column 1 and column 2. If column 1 is null, it returns column 2. Else, return column 1. This is the functionality of NVL. So before applying on our SQL query, which is a line 41, let us do it a very simple example on the NVL. Now let us say, I'll just say null, comma, hello, comma, NVL world news, like this. From GL. Just see now. Now what we are trying to see here, in this one, the second column got printed, and here the first column got printed. So that is what it says, right? Line number 43, it says that NVL contains two columns. If your column 1 is null, it will return your second column. If column 1 is not null, it will return the first column. Okay, let us say what will happen if both columns are null. Obviously, you'll get null only, because it doesn't bother what is the second column. If the first column is null, it simply returns the second one. It doesn't bother if it is null or not. Okay, now we'll try to make use of this NVL in our 41. Okay, so I'll just copy the 41 again. Sorry, here. Now what I'll do, so in this one, the commission, okay. So instead of, like, I can change my formula also, right? Instead of like this different way, I'll just say commission into 1.1, right? This is a very simple formula. Now what I'll do is, for this one, I'll just apply NVL. NVL of a commission is null, okay? If commission is null, or I can just like this, right? I'll write like this. If this value is totally null, I just want to print 500. This is very easier way, right? So this is how I can print my new commission by making use of NVL functionality. Okay. And let us see a few more examples of null. Just observe this one carefully. Null you can write in uppercase, lowercase, or mixed case, doesn't bother. Okay. Null comma null, null minus null, null into null, null by null. Okay. Anything with null is always null. So now instead of mentioning dual table, can't I mention the employee table? Yes, you can mention not only employee, you can mention any table, right? Let us say I want to mention some table called GL ledgers. Yes, you can mention that. If the table is a valid one, you can mention any valid table name. But why am I getting null? And also, how many rows I'm getting? I'm getting 216 rows. Why I'm getting 216 rows? Because observe here, in my GL ledgers table, select star from GL ledgers. So now how many rows are there here? There are 216 rows, okay. Now, as per Oracle valid syntax, in this select column, you can mention any column which is available in GL table, or you can mention any static value. Let us say if I mention one, it will work. Let us say if I mention sysdate, it will work. even though one and sysdate are not part of GLHS table, still it work because one is a static value, sysdate is a global function, which is available in each and every column. I mean to say, like, it's kind of function which is val, which can be executed from a select query. Can I mention the select? Like, can I mention, you know, like a character? Yes, you can mention character. Okay. Can I mention null? Yes, you can mention null. But let us, if you mention some a column name like this ledger name without single quotes, if this ledger name column is not available, then you'll get an error. Ledger name is not available. Okay. But let us say I have a, I'll try to mention a valid column name, like a name, which is a valid one. Then we got the data. Okay. Now, so get back to our null value functionality, right? Coming to the next one, column alias. So column alias, why do we use it? So generally, like, it is preferable when you want, when you mention, like, if you are trying to calculate something, you want, you, when you're trying to calculate a new column value based on your requirement, and you want to mention a proper business name for it, so that you can easily identify what value it is providing, then you use a column alias. Okay. And there are different ways you can mention. You can mention, if you, you can use it as keyword, and if at all, if you want to mention space in your column name, then you have to enclose that in a double quotes. That's a functional, that's how you, that's a syntax of column alias. Okay. Now, next, coming to the other one, concatenation operator. So we use piping symbol to, like, to perform the concatenation operator. Let us see this example. So let us say F and a user. So this is my, this is another table I want to consider. Let us say I want to consider, I want to say that, in like a user ID for username is like that. I want to print it. So what I want to do is, like, I want to print user ID for username, something like this. Okay, now what I have done, so I just concatenated the static text, right? I just concatenated the static text. This is how we can make use of the piping symbol. Okay, or let's try to use some other table name so that we'll have a valid valid example. I'll just use a per user table. Okay, now observe the errors also. Whenever you get an error, try to observe them, because from the errors we learn a lot. Because when everything goes when everything goes smoothly, right, the learning is very well, very limited. But whenever you get the hurdles, whenever you get set of errors, try to understand them. From them we can understand, we can learn many things actually. Okay, just observe here what it is doing. Just observe the line number and column number. It clearly telling line number 59 is you are having some error, and column 14. And what is error number? It is telling the error, like generally whenever you get any error, it tells you what is the error number with a, like, it starts with aura followed by the error number. Okay, 000942 is the error number. And what it is telling, table or view does not exist, because in the from clause, either you can mention, what all you can mention in the from clause, you can mention either table or a view, nothing more than that. Okay, and it is not a valid one. Okay, means this table name is wrong. So just per users wrong. Okay, so per user table is not available. The table, valid table name is per people F. So this is a valid table name. Now what I want to print is, I just want to print the full name of an employee. So I have the columns like first name, last name, and person ID. I want to print full name. How I want to print it? I just want to concatenate by separating them with a hyphen. So I just want to print like this. Let us say last name. The existing column names are last name and first name. Okay. First of all, I'll just execute this one. And what I want to print, I want to print a full name. Full name is my column alias. How do I want to concatenate? I'll just say last name underscore first name. So this is how I want to print it. Okay, we got some error. Just see. And what it is telling? Okay, I'll just remove this first, okay, and see what is the issue, whether it works or not. Yeah, it is working. But when I mention column alias, why it was not working? Let us see. Full name is working. So what was the issue earlier? That's fine. So you can mention as. Fine. So this is how we can make use of a concatenation operator. And here, if you observe, it is not showing the concatenation. It is not showing the underscore, right? But actually, it is showing. It is just because of the SQL developer issue. But if you just here, you can see the underscore. Okay. But this is one of the kind of a bug, I can say. Or you know, like the text, the like when you see the text, right? It doesn't seem to be underscore available here, but it is available. Okay. So make sure that you see them properly. Yep. Coming to the thing, the literal character strings are a static text. So we have seen these examples, right? Like how do we concatenate? How do you append a static text? So these static texts doesn't need to be available, right? It cannot be available, I can say directly. It cannot be available here. If you observe, I mentioned underscore, it is not available in my table, right? It is not a column name. Static text is static text. You just want to append some text to your column name and I want to see a new value for your column. And whatever you're doing here, right? Now let us say I just appended this new column name. It is not available in database table, right? This is just an ad hoc execution of your query, and it is just available whenever you execute. That's it. It doesn't get stored in the database table. Okay. Now, so how do you eliminate a duplicate row? You can just mention distinct keyword. And when you mention distinct, you can mention a single column name or you can mention multiple column names. What is the functionality of distinct? Distinct eliminates the duplicate rows. Okay. So distinct just eliminates duplicate rows. It's kind of filtering in your Excel sheet. So here, if you observe, when you use an Excel sheet, I just want to show you Excel sheet, the same set of data. So now let us say what I have highlighted. I highlighted the rows and here I highlighted the columns, right? This is how we can just see the convention, right? Generally, if you're expertizing the Excel, right? This is how we can just try to correlate with your database table with Excel sheet. So horizontal rows and vertical columns. And if you are trying to filter, let us say, if you want to hide something, nothing but you're trying to hide them from the select clause. If you want to filter the rows, then you're applying them on the where clause, which we have not discussed in this particular session. Okay. Now, coming back. Yeah. Coming to the other one, like how do you display table structure? So as of now, we have seen the different set of tables, right? But what is a table structure? Table structure is nothing but in your table, how many columns are there? What is the data type of each particular column? And what is the size of each particular column? And whether it's a null or a not null. What do you mean by null and not null? Not null means like you cannot store empty value. You cannot store null value in that particular table. Here, if you observe in this example, for department number, it says not null. It means that department number cannot be null. Always, it should have a value. That's what it means, right? Now, let us try to execute this one, like a describe EMP and execute. That's it. So now you just got the thing, right? Here, if you observe, in this particular table, all the values can be null except EMP number. All the values can be null except EMP number. Let us see this example. I can show you the insert command for this one. Let us say insert EMP into EMP, EMP number values. Let us say 777. Right, what is telling? Okay, so there are some set of triggers which are available on this, which it is not allowing, right? So what I'll do is I'll just create a new one. Let us say create table XX EMP. Okay. Okay. You can just ignore this one, or there are a number of ways we can do it. New table. So I'll just mention column name XX EMP. Maybe it is available or something like that. I'll just say XX EMP 7. I'll just mention column 1, not null. That's it. Okay, this is one of the easiest way. XX EMP 7. What is our table name? XX EMP 7. This is my table name, right? So what we have done, we have created a single column and not null, okay, and the varchar. So now let us see this one. Insert into this table name, mention column name, mention values, okay. Let us say I'll just mention test. Now one row got inserted. Just see here, select start from XXEMP7. We should be able to see the data. But let us say I'll try to insert null value in it. I'll try to insert null value in it. What I'll do is I'll just remove this one and just try and see what is the issue. What it is telling? Missing expression, right? Let us say, I'll just say null. Now see properly, right? Now what it is telling, cannot insert null, right? Earlier, you know, like it is saying missing expression. It was understanding that like you're not passing any value. That is why, you know, it is not considering a valid DML statement. But here, if you observe carefully what it is telling, it is clearly telling that this is the error number. I cannot insert null into this particular column, okay? So this is how you can consider, you know, this is the error which you generally get it when you're trying to insert a null value into a not null column, okay? So coming to the next one, like you can try to check out the database table structure of any of the database table, right? Okay. And coming to the end of the session, so far we have seen some of the basic examples of select clause, from clause, and also we have seen how the null works. We also have seen how describe works, distinct works, column alias works, and mathematical expression works, and null value function, right? So yep, thank you.